Savannah. It's an incredible story. A mother and daughter now side by side. Celeste Corcoran lost both her legs in the blasts, and her 18-year-old daughter, Sydney, nearly bled to death from a severed artery. In a Today Rock Center exclusive, I was able to speak with them in the hospital room. They're sharing, reunited and recovering. Celeste and Sydney are getting stronger each and every day, but as you know, Savannah, with their injuries, it's going to be a long road physically and emotionally, but they have such an incredible support system. In fact, their whole family says they're not just Boston strong, they're Corcoran strong. Oh. So,
well, they are certainly proving that, and it's so wonderful that the gentleman came and said, I had the same.
It is a Marine, exactly, a wounded veteran who came in and just lifted their spirits when they needed it most.
So he personified hope for sure.
Absolutely.
Natalie, thank you. And I know
good morning, guys. Hey. The train keeps rolling here. We have a champion now for 4 weeks in a row. The drum roll, please. It is the dog that can't catch.
Wow.
My personal favorite, Driving Miss Crazy.
Oh,
a hilarious twist on the backseat driver.
About yourself.
Can you imagine her in about 20 years?
Oh, my gosh.
Back to your television producer.
We should point out August won that argument. He turned around and drove.
That's it.
So he did it. She was told. Click number three. He was here with us this week. AJ Clemente, the anchor who's out of a job after just one show. Okay, our click number four, I gotta say, another great one. Kate McKinnon does an impersonation of Ellen DeGeneres, the reigning champion, the dog that can't catch. It's a good race this week.
It's a very good race. Really, thanks very much.
Well, earlier we gave you a preview of Matt's interview with Martha Stewart. Well, Jay Leno and his friends at Tonight Show are having a little fun with it. Take a look. That's a promo. I will tune in for that.
I'll watch.
Yes. Tuesday on Today.
Say, Martha, do you like Gladiator movies?
Still ahead, your favorite soap opera is going digital, but first, this is
stop by to help us out this morning, Miss Tamron Hall.
They let me in. Yeah.
Security.
Wow.
This is good. News Nation.
No.
It is. The News Nation is out in full force.
News
on the plaza
Nation,
this morning.
Yes, definitely.
Let's get to our take three. Take one is a story we've been talking about all week. It's these furloughs because of the sequester that have led to delays and cancellations of flights at airports, leaving a lot of people frustrated.
Yes.
That it came about because of the outcry of people who use planes and left alone some of the other things that are hurt by the sequester, namely Head Start, preschool for low-income families, Meals on Wheels. Mm-hmm. Those cuts remain in place. By the White House's account, 70,000 preschoolers will not have Head Start because of what's happening due to sequestration. So a little imbalance.
Yeah, well, the whole point of the sequester deal, but now we're seeing this piecemeal where like, most attention and gets results. And do we really want our country to run that way? It's crazy.
Well, I think it goes without saying, too. I mean, so many are hurting from the sequestration. I mean, a lot of people losing hours, losing, you know, their jobs in the process as well. So. Now, there has to be some sort of resolution fairly quickly.
And they're the silent victims because, again, we're hearing about the air travelers because you've got pilots getting on the plane saying, that 1 hour to Head Start mom.
I heard that this week.
You know, I saw one story on a Head Start mom, I think, in Ohio, who is like, I don't know what to do.
Right.
You know, it's crazy.
Not to mention seniors who need Meals on Wheels.
Yep.
Let's go to take two. This is just a beautiful magazine cover. Boston Magazine, 1 week after the events up there.
That's a simple
gorgeous.
Statement.
Yeah. The headline reads, we will finish the race. Yeah.
They should put that in a museum there in Boston because that is just amazing.
Beautiful?
It's like an art installation.
When I clicked on the link, you know, you see.
Some of the people, even Natalie, you talked to up there who've lost legs and said, they're going to give me some new legs and I'm going to make it across the finish line again next year with my new legs.
That's right, exactly. I mean, just to see. I mean, you've heard so much that the Boston strong, but you're really seeing it among the victims who, you know, they have a long way to go still, emotionally, physically,
financially
but,
as
and
well.
Financially. Sure. Yeah. I mean, this is just the beginning of what they have to face. I mean, you know, the insurance won't cover a lot of the things that they're going to need.
And we can't forget them because this, you know, this will fade into memory, and we have to keep remembering them because this is going to be something, as you said, it's going to be
living with this new reality. But to hear. The positive message, and you know, in fact, the mother and daughter who I interviewed, you're going to see that again tonight on Rock Center, to hear what they have to say is such inspirational message. And really, you know, they don't hate the bombers who did this. They say, I believe, you know, that young man, those two young men were sick.
And that's really it. Wow. They don't hate them, though.
Wow. Pretty
it's
graceful.
Extraordinary. Yeah.
Well, then hopefully that iconic cover of Boston Magazine will help people remember.
Yeah.
Let's move to our take three, a little bit lighter here. If you want to feel old, I'm about to give you a birthday.
Uh-oh.
Sunday marks the 10th anniversary of iTunes.
Wow.
It's been 10 years since iTunes
came out. I was 8 when they started that.
You were really?
I was a baby. Yeah, I think for the most part, we all go online now and just buy singles.
I was just looking at my closet.
And they were I've got all these CDs. I said, what am I going to do with this?
I know.
And so many of them probably duplicated.
Right, yes. Absolutely.
Right.
You know, there's the iTunes Match thing with who's got the time.
You know. Remember like Tower Records and when you would...
Oh, yeah.
I guess
vinyl.
A record, a CD. I mean, no one even knows what that is.
My Lilo's 14, has no idea what a record is.
Yeah. Well, but interesting, though, I have read recently, though, that vinyl is making a comeback.
Yeah, with all the DJs, all the hip kids are now DJs.
A lot of people, you know, realize that it's sort of... The sound quality of vinyl is far beyond.
Warmer.
It's much warmer, much richer. You hear the bass. It just, you know, you get all of that. Where you don't get that.
I'm still holding on for the comeback of the Laserdisc.
The 8-track.
No, the 8-track.
Exactly.
We want the 8-track.
They had a short window.
Let's bring the 8-track back.
It was like a year.
That Laserdisc, that was it. Boom. These giant platters. Who thought that was a good idea? Hey, let me get something the size of my head. No, twice as big. And put it in there. Wow.
There's some poor person right now saying that was my idea.
Seemed like a good idea.
At the time. It ended up being what we have now with Blu-ray, right?
Yeah.
I mean, isn't that sort of the same technology?
But
yes.
Much
tiny,
smaller.
Mini.
Yeah.
Do you know how many songs you have, iTunes, on your
I don't know the number.
I have the same playlist that I've had over and over again. I tend to, like, just go back to it. I update it every now and again.
I wonder if that's a woman thing or not, because my hack's four.
Real quick, last album you all bought, do you remember even?
Leela James. I bought it yesterday.
Online?
Oh, so you, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Well, even just like...
Even a CD.
CD.
Oh, CD?
Uh-oh.
Do they sell
CDs?
Yeah,
that's,
sure they do.
Sure.
Yeah.
Know where I hang.
Really?
You hang 8, 9 years. I'm going to say... Mystical, maybe. Danger. You remember
the
Mystical?
Rapper Mystical?
Okay.
Go, Willie.
He likes his rap.
Yeah,
he does. No, Mr. Ridgewood. Mr. 201.
Ridgewood. Exactly. Mr. 201. Mr. Bergen County.
Well, now that we move from Mr. 201, you're Ms. 411. What's our news?
Okay, let's get right to it. In the news this morning, Boston Marathon bombing suspect Yohar Zarnaev was moved overnight from the Boston hospital where he'd been held since his arrest to be up to date with the Royals now.
Wow.
Okay. Need a little motivation perhaps to hit the gym this morning? Well, not.
What is wrong with you two?
He was this close to doing the Iron Cross.
Not real.
No, not real.
Okay, here's the deal. During Natalie's newscast, callus on his hand from where, and he's going like this, and then Tamron's going like that. So why would you believe that that's a real?
That's what I'm saying.
Because it's all about you.
Myself.
Exactly.
Yes. Oh,
we know how hard it is to lift.
Not pandas, she said.
Okay. Red pandas.
Let's just do the weather, Al. How about that?
This is real. Okay, let's show you what we've got. We are
Life to Live are coming back, and they're going digital. The shows will be available Monday through Thursday on Hulu and iTunes with a Friday recap show. Erica Slade, ladies.
Thank you.
This is great for the fans. The fans have spoken. I understand there's a Facebook page even with some 4 million followers. They demanded this, so now it's happening.
I know. So, thanks to Rich Frank and Jeff Watnitz, who run Prospect Park.
Do the soaps pick up right back where they left off? I mean, it seems like Victoria Lord, your character, has been through it all, including nearly dying three times.
Right. So I've been dead a couple of times.
She's been dead a couple
of times. But in daytime, you never die.
So she's also sort of a online integrative plot lines. But. All right. And we'll tell you that it all starts April 29th. Ladies, thanks so much.
Thank you.
We're back right
up next week. Coming up next week.
That's great.
You can catch more of Matt's actual interview with Martha next week here on Today.
I just love how they do that, though. It's pretty good. They even found a voiceover guy. He sounds just like the announcer.
Yep. Was that The Bachelor? I think they spliced The Bachelor in there.
Kind of looked like
water
scenes. A little bit of that.
I'm Willie Geis, along with Al Roker, Natalie Morales, and Lester Holt inside Studio 1A. Coming up this half hour, do you ever lie to your doctor, maybe just a little bit?
Yeah, I sent you the bill.
Those among others. I'll tell you why they might get you into a little trouble coming up.
All right. Also ahead in celebrity news, a sneak peek at Beyonce's newest single, plus Ben Affleck becoming a doctor. We're going to tell you what that's all about.
Right. My son, the doctor. And an amazing performance from an impressive group of singers on their way, literally, to Carnegie Hall. First off, let's find out what's coming up on the weekend edition of Today.
Well, we're going to have the latest in the Boston on Today.
All right, Lester, thanks a lot. We'll look forward to that. Now Al's got a check of the weather.
All right, as we look ahead to the weekend, we'll start off with...
For E! News, Alicia, good morning.
Good morning.
Headlines and Beyonce fans eagerly anticipating her newest album, her fifth album. And there have been some leaks of some of the songs, but her newest song, actually, Standing in the Sun, is featured in an H&M ad. Tell us more about that.
H&M ad was just... She's very hands-on mom.
So cute.
15 months.
All right, moving on to another one of our favorites around here. Ben Affleck, now the Oscar winner, apparently is pledging to live on $1.50 a day.
Yes.
Now, what is this all about? It's great.
Get a day. I didn't do
so soon to be Dr. Ben Affleck. Is that right? He's getting an honorary degree at Brown University. You are hot hashtags. And Jessica Alba, as we reported earlier, she's trending today. She talked about how she lost all that baby weight after her having her second child, her daughter, back in 2011. So what's the scoop there?
Okay, so she did what some people say are unusual, but I've heard this before.
You know what I'm talking about.
I'm just saying. The actress says, you know, she's got to focus on the body, so she did it.
She looks amazing. It's working. Whatever. I think it has to do with jeans a little more than anything else.
I think so, too.
Okay, The Rock, apparently, Dwayne Johnson had a little surgery this week. Now, this goes back to that bout that he had at MSG. Is that right?
That's right. For WWE team around him that focus on his food plan.
And then he's Fast and Furious is coming back out
busy
again.
Busy man.
Yes, he is. And Michael Bublé, finally, is he guest hosted here, as you saw, probably on Wednesday.
Yes.
And he, I understand, serenaded some New York commuters. Is that right?
He did it. He was on the 67th Street subway.
Girls, great stuff. Thanks always.
Natalie.
And have fun at the White House Correspondents' Dinner. She's headed up there. Coming up next, some beautiful music from a chamber choir on their way to Carnegie Hall, literally right after this.